Howdy folks, welcome back to SnowRunner on Factory Grounds, picking up right where we left off. We have to get these two short logs back to Factory Grounds. We're actually on Antonovsky Nature Reserve right now. Let's see. Well, if I get... Well, I'm going to get stuck in that puddle. But I need to get back to here. Came down here, just going cross country, and that was a real bastard. So we'll try going back up on the road and see how that works out until we get up here, and then I'm going to cut straight across. Well, let's see how we get out of this spot we're in. This trailer I'm pulling is a two-spot, four-axle flatbed that's been converted by a modder to haul short logs. I didn't follow that piece of road, so I didn't pick up any of those waypoints. And the waypoint system is too stupid to just move on to where you are. Seems like a fairly stable trailer back there. As far as two-spot flatbeds go, I've always preferred the four-axle one. The wooden sideboard version dumps over every time you touch it, unless you drive very slow and you're very careful. I can get it there without dumping it. But like I say, slow and careful. You see, this one is going at a pretty good clip over some rough terrain, and it's staying with me. A root in the road does that. Sabre talks so much about their realism. That's not realism. When you drive over a root, a tree root, on a dirt road, you just press it down. It doesn't lift your whole vehicle, make it jump in the air. If Sabre wants to stick to their realism, they should stick to it across the board. All this horrible music. Now this has to go here. So I guess something like this. Get up here on the tracks. Go through the station somehow. Transfer to the dirt road. Saber's trying to tell me that a 12 by 12 is gonna have trouble with that muddy little hill. Or do they want you to do the entire map? There's my barrels. Do the entire map in low range. There doesn't seem to be that much content to these two maps. And what content there is has just been regurgitated from every other map they've ever done. So all they've done to create their Season 5 region here is make the terrain so difficult that every job is gonna take an hour to do. There isn't going to be anything quick and easy. You can forget that concept. Now try and go through there. They got shit in the way. Try and go up the tracks. They got shit in the way. Maybe I can cut over this corner up here. Come on, climb over the dam. Little teeny bit of concrete there. Nope, it's like an invisible wall. It just won't allow me to turn left. Won't allow me to turn right. Nope. this is a bridge. Well, I don't have to continue that way. Nice looking scenery. But they really turned up the difficulty. Look at hit this water. Dead in your tracks. There's that much of the job done. Now let's go back to the garage. Truck store. You know what? I can't buy the 10x10 on this region. No point in even looking. I've already done that exercise. So there's gonna be a 10x10 in here either, because I already did that exercise in another episode. Or when I was trying to create this 10x10, I went through all that bullshit. Let's see, saddle high, and small cargo box, and oh, the crane is there already. So that's it. Now it's reconfigured for different work. We're going to take it up to where I can latch on to that trailer and bring it down here. Luckily, this job I can do from either side. So And with the new bridge, I don't have to go across there. So I can just cross this puppy and follow that road up to there. I'd be tempted to get the fuel. If I could do three spots and still have the fifth wheel in place. But with the three spot or the four spot bed, flatbed, or whatever you want to call it, with the three spot or the four spot, you can't have the fifth wheel. That seems to be in the way. I could take that, go grab my four spot trailer and pick up the three oil barrels, but there isn't any such thing as doing something quick in this game. And I would imagine the job I'm doing is going to eat up the rest of my time. Unless I can get up there and back quick. I got back here with the logs in less time than it took me to go get them in the first place. Of course, I going down there, I was coming all the way from the trailer store. Didn't have to travel as much distance coming back. I've got to get that scrap pile job. This. Except close. Doing it this way, it doesn't change the job that I'm working on. Two metal beams. Okay, from there across the bridge we have yet to fix, and over to there. So fixing the bridge first. would be preferable, and that needs a beam and cement. That's down on the other map. There we are. Attach trailer and then go to the restroom. Be right back. All right, let's see how we're getting this down there. I looked at it, but let's look at it again. We have to go through the obstacle course or whatever. Get back on that road. And it goes straight down. And this appears okay. You can knock it over. Fix my suspension. Whoops. Hidden buttons. In the wrong order. All right. Let's do this shit. There we go. Look at that. Opposing Kennys. Yay. All right. Well, I have a decision to make because I sure would like to fix old bridge, but that means going for concrete besides a metal beam from up here. I could do fuel the old gas station without leaving the map. I have 25 minutes left. I think I can get old bridge done using one truck to grab the two metal beams, and this truck, well, I can go get the concrete on the trailer and put the one metal beam in the basket and then zip over there and do it. Sure. But I'm not going to try and go through the rail yard. Screw that. Here we come, cement. The wheels on this thing seem to handle the terrain better. Oops, gotta go up here. Pumpkins. I know there's a two jobs right here, but I'm not slowing down for jobs. Might have to slow down for a poll, but then it's back to the races, racing the clock. You can't just bash those out of your way. You'll get 150 or so damage. The damage numbers you get on this region are a lot higher. Yeah, there's the cement. So, you know, we haven't been through here. We'll take that route. There's got to be a way to get past this bridge. There's more map that goes up to the north and then comes back around, but I ain't gonna mess with that. Stop already. Have it already? Well, I got cement before, so I would have had to come through this way. That's the sawmill. I don't know what the formula is, but you have to take logs into the sawmill to get planks out. Maybe we'll check the formula on the way back through. Let's see, let's take the loop. Woo! Think it's gonna give me shit about the trailer being in the wrong place. Ah, oh, let's see. One cement right there. One lousy cement. All the way down here for one lousy cement. I'm just looking to see if anything else needs cement. Deliver to the water tower. Needs a couple cement, but that's on this map. So, not gonna worry about it right now. Off we go into the wild blue yonder as soon as I do this. Want to hit that and see what the formula is for making logs. It'd be quicker to get out of here if I just ignored it and went up that left-hand split. Looks like it's one for one, one medium, one plank. Yeah, I could have went past that trailer without banging into it, but I didn't want to. there's a road going that way, like there might be an actual crossing over there. But I'm gonna do it right here. Gotta say, this truck is handling the terrain a lot better than the 12x12. Because just like that, we're back at the gateway. Oh, I'm gonna go kill my alarm. This is when I had it set to get me up for work, 5 a.m. Got back just in time for the music to end. Good. I didn't have to listen to it. Now I run straight back up through the middle. To get a piece of metal. The metal for metal. Minutes in. Looks like we're gonna get two jobs done instead of half a job. Kind of surprised I haven't bounced that cement off the trailer yet. Been doing some serious whipping around. Did I take the wrong way through the village? Damn it. See, I jinxed myself. Where did it end up? Oh, right there, underneath my trailer. It's not gonna pack like that, but maybe I can get it on. You know, and I'm not gonna be able to reach the trailer. I guess we'll have to do this the other way around. See, I mentioned it. That's what fucked me over. The only thing I'm going to be able to put it in is the truck. So I guess we'll put the metal on the trailer. I know that was a steep cliff, but trying to make that corner with the telephone pole there wasn't gonna happen. If I'd gone through the village by a different route, I wouldn't have had that hard corner. There's one beam, one cement. This one doesn't have a deep a snorkel as that 12x12, so I'll go this way. Fixing the bridge still doesn't fix that pipeline over there. Blammo. Yay. I can start uploading these to the one that I've been uploading all night. I'm sure is done except for the processing, which can take anywhere from an hour to a day, depending on what YouTube is doing. But if it's not done processing before I leave for work, I'll just schedule it to go up a couple hours later or something. These two might be up. Might be up by around dinner time tonight. Anyways, Thanks for watching, and catch you next time.